Hey guys, how you doing? Look, it's indoor grilling with Mainly Butch. Okay, we are going to. My wallet. I will lose it if I don't put it somewhere. Right here next to the refrigerator. It's right there. If anybody, if I post on Facebook that I lost my wallet, it's right next to the refrigerator. I lost my wallet yesterday. I never found it. I had to go get all new IDs and everything. There is a lost wallet somewhere with all of Mainly Butch's information in it and $21. Alright, so. This is what we got going on here. We're going to cook up some swordfish. I got a nice piece of swordfish right here. Beautiful. Nice, beautiful piece. Nice size for me. It's about an inch thick. You know, maybe an inch and a quarter. Okay. And I have this rig right here. This is an indoor barbecue grill. Okay. I have a gas stove, as you can see here. So I'm going to turn on the gas burner, nice and high, all right, I'm going to put the ring over the gas burner, so the flames are coming up through the center. On the outside of the ring, there's a trough that goes all the way around, as you can see, all right. In that trough, I'm mixing some lemon juice with some water. I'm going to go with about 3/4 cup, okay, see how much I can fit. I'm going to pour that into the trough. It's overflowing a little bit. We're going too fast. That's going to make whatever I'm cooking here, which in this case is the fish, nice and moist. Now I'm going to put the cover, this is the grill right here, over the top of this. Very carefully as not to burn myself, like I just did. Alright, so we'll let that get a little warm there. I'm going to give it a quick spray. Probably, nope, don't spray flames. Don't spray things that are already on a gas stove. It goes poof, and I almost gave you a big fireworks show. So, I mean, before I do that, I'm going to wash my hands real quick. I got a phone call. I'll be back. Oh, hey, you're back. I'm going to take the sweet potato fries out of the oven. I want to put a trivet or something down. I got a trivet on the counter to lay the cookie sheet on. Use a hot mitt. Woo. There they are coming out of the oven. Sweet potato chips. They're very, very good. And they're very good for you. As long as you take it easy with the salt. I don't take it very easy with the salt. I like salt. So I'm a heavy salter on my chips. But I'm not diabetic or anything like that. So I don't know. I guess I feel like I can get away with salt, with salting it. Take them all off, add them to the plate. They're good hot or cold, so they cool down pretty quick because they're really, really thin. I like mine nice and thin. Ooh, hot! Some people like them thinner. I mean, thicker. You can't get much thinner than I'm making them. That's pretty damn thin. Take my pan to the sink. I got some dishes. I like to keep my kitchen clean as I go. So I'm always cleaning as I go along when I cook. Run some cold water on that puppy. It'll cool down. Cotton wood, clean up there. Fish is coming right along. She's about a third of the way cooked through one side there. I like to cook it slow. Want to keep the juice in there. These sweet potato fries are absolutely beautiful, don't you think, folks? Look at that. Look at that. Sweet potato fries. You can use ketchup and stuff on them, but why do you want to ruin or hide? Stop wiggling. Why do you want to ruin or hide the taste of great sweet potato fries with the ketchup? So I got my lemon caper butter. I'm setting myself a nice place here at the table. Got my coffee ready for after dinner. I got my coffee all set up and ready in my Keurig machine for after dinner. I'm going to flip that piece of fish now. Hold on. Whoa! I scooted it right off the stove. Let's try that one more time. Oh, there we go. All right, my wash is boiling over. I want to turn that down. Get a little air in there. That fish will cook right up. So, this has been the cooking of a fine swordfish dinner, which I love swordfish, and I've been eating a lot of fish lately that I had a craving for, so evidently my brain needs food, because fish is very, very good for your brain. I'm still a little upset that this is a Canadian caught swordfish. It's a Maine swordfish that swam into Canadian waters, that's all I can say. And Canadians caught it, and Market Basket in New Hampshire is selling all foreign seafood. They are sitting here in one of the biggest seafood production ports in the country, okay, between Kittery, Maine, Portsmouth, New Hampshire, and the whole coast of Maine right here. And they're bringing in lobster from other countries. Lobster, guys! We lobster fish here! They're bringing in shrimp, salmon, everything. The entire seafood case at Market Basket in Portsmouth is nothing but foreign seafood. They're even bringing in scallops from Chile, you know, and it's just crazy. How do you support the local American economy by doing that kind of crap? Especially the local. We are huge, huge fishing people here. You know, it's a way of life. It's a culture. And they go and to the grocery store where we go to spend our money that we made fishing and make us buy out-of-country seafood? It doesn't make any freaking sense. They could get it cheaper shipping-wise and less price buying it right off the boat right here. You know, I know that Hannaford does a lot of local buying wherever their stores are. They'll buy vegetables from the local farmers. They'll buy the pumpkins from the local farmers. They'll buy meat from the local farms. You know, they go out of their way to use local stuff. Market Basket's really got some catching up to do. So, my fish is cooking. Let me take you over and show you. I like this camera sometimes because it can be mobile if I make it mobile. It's got like a 17-foot. No, not 17-foot, but got a long cord. So, there's the fish cooking, as you can see, on the stove. And here we got the squash cooking over here. So, that's getting pretty good. Let me turn it around so you can see the other side a little bit. That's the skin that you're seeing on this side here. You're seeing the skin right here. I'm gonna look at the meat and see how well cooked it is through. I'm not a big fan of this dark meat. I like the white meat more. This only had a little bit of dark meat in it. And I like it enough, you know, that I'll eat it. There. That's just about done. Throw some lemon caper butter on that sucker and it will be awesome. So let me put you back over here. Stabilize things. There we go. So anyway, yeah. That's cooking in the kitchen with Mainly Butch. And I am one hell of a cook, too. I'm going to make a femme damn good Butch husband one of these days. So, I just need to find and get the right femme here with me. Alright, bye. There it is, folks. Beautiful swordfish dinner. Sweet potato fries. Nice glass of milk. These salt and pepper shakers came from the Marine Corps dining hall when my father was in the Marine Corps. I've had them. They're about 60 years old now, so, yeah, so that's my meal. I'm going to sit down now and have that and enjoy the hell out of it. And I will be vlogging more later on tonight, so stay tuned for Mainly Butch. More Mainly Butch later. I have to say, this meal was fantastic. I like the squash when it's got a little crunch to it still. You know, don't cook it till it's limp. Nothing is good limp. Oh, I take that back. Spinach is pretty good limp. I like canned spinach, which is really odd. Popeye the Sailor Man. Well, what kind of an idiot steals $100 million worth of artwork, Picasso's and Matisse's and Monet's, over in Rotterdam, and they're worthless because there's no market, no black market for hot artwork. Nobody will touch them. So they're just basically lost. Unless they're found in the next few days for at least a generation until somebody discovers them somewhere with the idiot thieves have hidden them and returns them to their rightful owners in proper place. You know, in my opinion, artwork like that belongs to the people, because, you know, a private collector can own it, but he needs to display it so the people can see it, so people can understand, you know, how incredible these artists were or are. Great, great, great chips. I'm a big bread and butter fan, too. Yeah, my appetite and my desire to cook has returned. I have to be really careful to eat good food like this and not a bunch of cake and candy and stuff, you know, so I don't put on a lot of sugar weight. And as much as I've been working lately, you know, physically doing a lot of stuff, you know, as long as I keep doing that kind of stuff and eating right, I should stay pretty good with the weight. You know, I don't tend to gain a ton of weight. I will gain a little over the winter. I'm like a bear, baby. You know, you gotta put on a little weight to fight off that cold. I always usually drop it by May. So, usually I'll put on 10 pounds and then take them off again by May. I'm not really, really worried about it. It feels good to eat again. It took basically a year, if you think about it, with me and my body and the full recovery from that infection I had that started at the end of August 2011, you know, with the tooth that got pulled out. It's taken basically until now, you know, because I dealt with a lot of stuff, you know, that got in there because of the pain and the illness. I got depressed and the depression spiraled, and, you know, there's just a lot of things can happen. You know, you got to take care of yourself because you are a beautiful, beautiful person. Everybody's a beautiful person. And it's up to you to take care of yourself. So anyway, I'm going to finish eating this meal and I'll vlog more later.